I don't believe in the word perfect. It means there's nothing more to improve on, nothing to get better at. But that is never the case. There's no perfect dish, perfect painting, perfect person, so let alone a perfect phone. But when OnePlus announced their OnePlus 8 Pro, it was quite literally perfect. This phone had everything. Flagship camera, spotless UI, and a beautiful screen. And don't even get me started on performance. But that was only the beginning. My initial impressions with this phone was like a dream. The exterior was beautiful with its sleek curves, smooth touch, and that gorgeous glacial green color. Paired with that beautiful body was an equally beautiful screen. You needed to see the 1300 nit 6.78 inch Quad HD 120Hz 10-bit HDR 10+ Fluid AMOLED display to truly experience its glory. Every touch of the finger responded instantly and animations flew by. With its decent pair of speakers, media consumption on this device was very enjoyable, although I wish it had more bass and a more balanced sound signature for a fuller sound. The Snapdragon 865 UFSO 3.0 storage and LPDDR5 RAM was able to tackle anything. Apps opened in an instant, every game ran smoothly, and nothing ever lagged or stuttered. This phone also has great haptics that feel sharp and precise, and a speedy in-display fingerprint sensor. There's an alert slider to toggle between ring, vibrate, and silent, which I can't live without, and lastly, crazy fast warp charging. This phone is able to charge from 0 to 70% in just 30 minutes, and there's 30-watt wireless charging using OnePlus's proprietary charger as well. But if you use any generic cable or Qi charger, then you can only get 5 watts, which is pretty slow. Anyways, OnePlus finally included solid cameras that are almost flagship level. The main Sony 48-megapixel sensor is much bigger, with shots looking detailed and sharp, and with high saturation and contrast, although a little too much in my opinion. It also does decently well in low light, although it's no match for Google's Night Sight. The ultra-wide camera on this phone is among one of the best in the smartphone world. The detail captured is incredible, and color is mostly consistent with the main lens. The ultra-wide lens also has a motor that physically moves to allow for an amazing macro mode. Check out these shots. And finally, Oxygen OS. Along with the Pixel launcher, this is hands down the best Android skin. It has nearly the same feel as stock Android with more customizability and speed. The animations are optimized beautifully for this 120Hz display, and I would argue that Android 11 on this looks better than stock Android, and especially compared to other skins like One UI. You can't go back to any other software after using Oxygen OS. Or at least, that's what I thought. You see, the OnePlus 8 Pro, as beautiful and perfect as it is, lost its charm over time. It's time to unveil the ugly truth about this phone. Now, before you roast me in the comments, you should know that there are tons and tons of other angry users online with problems even worse than mine. Okay, starting with the cameras. OnePlus, don't call these flagships if they're half-baked. You give a useless color filter that was banned, and you lie to consumers about the telephoto lens that's not even that good. It is the same camera as the OnePlus 7 Pro that claimed an 8-megapixel camera with 3x zoom, but it was actually a 13-megapixel 2.2x camera that was cropped in. Yet they still have the guts to market this as a 3x optical zoom lens, but now using the words lossless instead of optical like before. It's garbage anyways. There's a severe lack of detail, it's horrible in low light, and it has inconsistent colors and a lack of contrast. And that brings me to portrait mode. One of the absolute worst portrait modes I've ever used in my life. Edge detection and colors are terrible and the result just looks horrible. Can't even focus properly. Honestly, my OnePlus 6T with Gcam takes way better portraits than this. And for video, there's a stutter at the beginning, severe audio sync issues, and horrible focus. I also think OnePlus is purposely trying to handicap the camera to make the OnePlus 9 Pro look better, because in their Android 11 update, OnePlus removed the new focus tracking system, that was actually pretty good and cool, and downgraded the portrait video mode to 1080p 30 frames per second from 4K 60. The selfie camera is also pretty bad and lacks 4K support in video like other flagships. With all these problems, I don't think OnePlus has the right to call this a flagship phone of flagship cameras. Now, the display. The hype about the display was short-lived once users started complaining about severe problems like hole punch banding, black crush, screen retention, and most commonly, green tint. For almost $1,000 USD, how is that acceptable? With my particular unit, I faced mild green tint and severe screen retention. Green tint is more visible in lower brightness, so OnePlus sneakily increased the minimum brightness to make it less visible, instead of trying to fix it. Screen retention is even worse. I could be texting my friends for 5 minutes and there's just an imprint of our chat stuck everywhere I go. I would have returned this phone if it wasn't for Oxygen OS, but OnePlus' software has absolutely gone down the drain. I've only gotten a few of the many promised software updates, and they're always months behind on security patches too. The big Oxygen OS 11 upgrade to Android 11 was just the big turning point. I still find it funny how it took them 3 hilariously failed attempts to deliver a half-baked, bug-filled Android 11 update. Each time, they would delete the update and try again because of their bugs. And even after their failed attempts, Oxygen OS has just been an absolutely terrible experience. Not just for me, but for many, many, many angry users. The phone has been consistently slow, laggy, and freezes out of nowhere. Apps are crashing all the time and even the system UI crashes. The whole phone just turns black and then pops up a little pop-up message saying, "Unfortunately, system UI has crashed." What in the world does that mean? And animations that are supposed to be fast just act choppy. Even the notifications are laggy. I'm not joking. Notifications sometimes don't come in at all until you open the phone and boom, a flood of notifications start piling in for minutes, vibrating the phone out of existence. Also, the battery life on this phone is getting worse and worse after each update. I can't even get 4 to 5 hours of screen on time anymore and have to charge 2 to 3 times a day depending on my usage. And lastly, the most annoying part of Oxygen OS. Bugs, bugs, and bugs. I swear, with every single update, they try to fix the bugs, but guess what? New ones come in. Their fingerprint scanner freezes, gallery app crashes after taking screenshots, notification shades getting stuck, and speaking of notifications, the stupid Android 11 media controller is always there, even if you're not playing anything. And every time I swipe it away, it magically appears back. But that's not all. There was even a time where images from social media sites got stuck on the screen, forcing a restart, and Google apps also started spazzing different shades of white whenever you used them. These were all real bugs, and even though they were fixed, OnePlus did acknowledge them, which I find really funny. Even still, the lag and freezes I encounter on this phone every minute is absolutely unacceptable. This is not the experience any consumer should feel. And this happened on my OnePlus 62, even after many, many resets. I gave OnePlus so many chances to fix and update their software, but they have just failed me and other consumers over and over again. You know what? I'm done. Now that the rant is over, I wanted to say that I am seriously not exaggerating anything I said by any means. On forums, you can find a whole community of OnePlus users who are way more mad than me. And honestly, I really wanted to love this phone, and it was the perfect phone for me, until OnePlus started to fall as a company. The promise of a smooth Android experience, gone. The promise of fast updates, gone. They even broke their promise of 3 years of updates in their budget Nord phones. If OnePlus can't listen to consumers and fix their problems, I'm sure they will start to lose many, many customers. Even a diehard OnePlus fan like me. Hey guys, if you stayed all the way to the end of the video, I wanted to give you guys a huge thank you for putting up with my ranting. If you liked this video, be sure to like this video, and if you didn't, remember to click the thumbs down button twice. Also, remember to subscribe down below for some awesome tech content. Alright, stay safe and see you guys later.